Hi, from this tutorial, I will share you how to set up your AR Spatial Anchor with Azure Cloud Unity package into your Unity project. You have to create new project and select template as 3D default template and give project name as AR Spatial Anchor with Azure Cloud. Then you have to locate your project. Click this three dots here and locate your project and create new project. Once open the project, you can import your Unity asset into your project. Go to asset, import package, custom package, and give your Unity asset package. From import Unity package window, you can check all these Unity package and import. Once imported the AR Spatial Anchor Unity package into your project, you can go to AR Spatial Anchors Scenes folder and load the basic demo. Go to Asset folder again and you can delete this scene folder here. Okay, then you have to configure your packages. So I'm going to Window Package Manager. So you have to add Azure Spatial Anchor SDK packages into your project. So we have already provided you a folder called Azure Spatial Anchor packages, or unless you can download from Azure Spatial Anchor documentation page, you can download this all platform core packages and Android or iOS packages to your local machine from download with web browser or download with npm. And I have already downloaded my Azure Spatial Anchor packages. I'm going to package manager window again, click this plus button and add packages from turbo. Once it click, you can see you have to provide the Azure Spatial Anchor zip files that we have downloaded before. So I'm going to that zip folder location, desktop, Azure Spatial Anchor packages. First, you want to put core package. So I provide com.microsoft-azure.spatialanchors-sdk.core. The version number is 2.9.0 and select and open it. It will take some time to load this Azure Spatial Anchor package. After core package is loaded, you can import your iOS or Android package into project. I'm going to click plus button and go to add package from tarball. According to your platform that you have built, you can choose the package you want, SDK for iOS or SDK for Android. I'm going to build my app into iOS, so I click sdk.ios and open it. Make sure your Azure Spatial Anchor SDK packages versions are 2.9.0, and also you want to sure about project, I use in AR Foundation. So I'm going to only registry. Go to AR Foundation. Yes, it's already imported AR Foundation. You can update it to 4.1.7, and also you want to update your AR Kit XR plugin to same version that I have mentioned in AR Foundation. Also, you want to update your AR Kit XR plugin to 4.1.7. If you are going to build this for Android, you have to import this AR Core XR plugin into your project. Once we have uploaded all the packages, you can build your Unity project. So I'm going to File, Build Setting, and change your platform that you are going to build. Once you switch the platform, you can add all the scenes except scene maker scene into your scenes in build window in build setting. Keep your menu scene in top of the list. Then you can go to player settings. For company name, you can give your company name. Go to other setting. Under other setting, you can see a camera usage description and location usage description. Change the value as given below. Okay, then go to XR plugin management and check whether AR Kit is enabled. If your desired platform is Android, click Android, switch your platform Android and switch platform. Go to player setting and player. Under other settings, if you enable Vulkan graphic API here, you have to remove that graphic API and make sure your minimum API level is API level 24, Android 7.0 Nougat. Then go to publish settings and check main Gradle template. If you are checking custom main Gradle template, you can see a main Gradle assets plugins Android, and you can see main template Gradle file is generated, and you can double click on main Gradle template.gradle. When you double click on it, it will open in Visual Studio or any code editor. In my case, it will open in Visual Studio Code. Under dependencies, if you are not seeing any code like these two, you have to copy this code from your documentation and paste into here. Then save your file and go back to your Unity editor. Now you can build your application for Android device. Go to File, Build Setting, and you can click Build button here. Okay, now you have successfully configured your project, but before the build, you have to create your Azure Spatial Anchor resource and configure the project, and also you want to publish your own Azure website to keep your anchor information. So from next two part, I will share you how to create your Azure Spatial Anchor resource and how to publish your Azure website. Hi, From this part, I will show you how to set up Azure Spatial Anchor resource to your project. First, you have to go to Azure portal and you have to create your Azure account and sign in into your Azure portal and go to create a resource button here and click it. And once you appear the create resource window, you have to search Spatial Anchor resource in the search bar and click enter. You can see Spatial Anchor resource here, and I'm going to select it. And once you select the Spatial Anchor resource, it will goes to the Spatial Anchor window here and click create button. From this step, we are going to create a new Spatial Anchor resource. So you can give any name for your resource name. I'm giving ECR Spatial Anchor. And for subscription, you have to give the default subscription here. And for resource name, you can give any resource name as for your resource name, or otherwise you can create a new resource group. So I will give my default resource group here, my resource group, and keep the location as East US and create the Spatial Anchor resource. Once I go to my home, you can see our Spatial Anchor that I have created before is showing up under recent resources. You can click your Spatial Anchor resource and it will pop up the overview of your Spatial Anchor, and you want to get the credentials from here and copy and paste into our Spatial Anchor Unity project. So you have to go to Assets, ECR, Spatial Anchors, Azure Spatial Anchor SDK, Resource Folder, and click Spatial Anchor Config File. Then you can see you have to fill credentials as Spatial Anchor Account ID, Spatial Anchor Account Key, and Spatial Anchor Account Domain. So I go back to my web panel here and copy the account ID from here and paste in it into account ID. And next, I'm going to access keys under settings and copy the primary key and paste it into Spatial Anchor account key. And also go back to overview and get the account domain from here, eastusmixedreality.azure.com, and copy to clipboard and paste it into Spatial Anchor domain. Okay, now you have put your credentials into your config file, and now you can build your app. Go to file and build setting and choose your preferred platform and select all the scenes that I have mentioned earlier. Click the build button. Hi, from this part I will show you how to publish your Azure website for your ECR Spatial Anchor project. From this web app, you can keep your anchor details like your anchor positions, anchor rotations, and also you can keep the information of object like object positions, object rotations. And also using this web API, you can post and get your anchor details. For that, we have to use Azure Sharing Services sample. Go to the sample folder, and we have already provided you this Sharing Services sample folder. or otherwise you can go to Azure GitHub page and go to Azure Spatial Anchor samples, and you can see and sharing services sample folder here. You can download this as a zip. Once you open the sharing services sample folder, you can see the sharing services solution and click on it. And you can see it will open the solution of sharing service. For run this sharing service solution, you have to open the Docker, start the Docker environment. Then right click on this sharing service solution and go to publish, publish to Azure, and you have to give your account details that you have created your Azure account. If any resource group that you have created before, it will show this section here, or otherwise you have to create new Azure app service. Once you go to new app service, you have to provide your app service name. I will give ECR Spatial Anchor. And it will show up our web URL here. ECR spatialanchor.azurewebsite.net, and give the subscription and the resource group that we have created before and click next. Then it will ask your registry name. Keep this registry as default and give region as East US, and you can give a pricing tier as a free or standard. Keep the storage account as existing and create your app service. I have already created my app service. When you publish your app, you can see this kind of website with your base URL ecr.website.net. I have created before as ecr spatialanchor.azurewebsite.net. You can see those are web API. Save your anchors by post, or you can get details of anchor by this get method. Also, we want to configure this base URL for our project. So I copy this website name from here and go to my Unity project and go to basic demo and click general configuration game object. And you can see under API configuration item, you have to put your website name and dash API dash anchors. You can get this web URL from here, from base URL, and other than that you have to put this dash API dash anchors after base URL. Once you put your API URL cloud anchor ID here, copy this URL, go to all the scenes, and in general configuration game object you have to put API configuration item as base URL that we have created before. And you can see all the scenes I have put my base URL with API anchors in general configuration game object under API configuration item. Yeah, that's about publish your website and configure your API URL cloud anchor ID in your Unity project. Thank you. Now you can build your project and enjoy ECR Spatial Anchor with Azure Cloud.